few housekeeping things first. Apparently, I don't know my choir's hometowns very well. Either that or there were some serious typographical errors in the program. So Sloan Dirk is actually from Cole Township, not Boundship, Pennsylvania. And somehow or other, Kaylee Bratcher is not from Warwicksburg, Pennsylvania. She's from a little town near Bel Air, Maryland. So I apologize to them and their families for messing that up in the program. Corral's program for the spring has had a genesis that started back on November 26th in the first semester when I learned of the passing of Stephen Sondheim. My goal at that point was to put a program together that would feature some of Sondheim's lesser known works and some of them that are somewhat better known as well. So that started things going in motion for me to do a program about the spring and to do a program about text painting, what it takes to make a work of art and to create visual and textual meaning with the musical phrase. So that, hence the title, came up as wordplay. As it turns out, Stephen Sondheim was also a very avid crossword puzzle creator and solver. So he liked words. He liked to put on internal rhymes in his works and do wonderful things, in addition to then his compositional skills, which also fit the text that he created so well. So that was the goal. And since Stephen Sondheim is of Jewish heritage, I wanted to do something in Hebrew, which Salomone Rossi is one of the most well-known composers of the Venetian Renaissance of Hebrew text music. So the first set, we have the legacy of wordplay from the Renaissance era, a piece by Rossi, and then an Ave Maria. Ave Maria is something that is a legacy for me, since I did that 45 years ago when I was an undergraduate student here, and I wanted to share that with my chorale as well. So that's the genesis of that. The British tradition of wordplay, I'll get to that in a little bit, and then we'll move it on from there. But you've heard enough of me speaking. You want to hear them to sing, and so do I. So we will give you our program, Wordplay by Chorale.
Oh,
seniors probably more than anyone else. But here we are singing Pale April, and it's a song about Cupid frolicking in the wilderness and bringing all the joys of spring. Shakespearean text, Michael Gray, and often they are in three parts, which is a good thing for smaller choirs. So these two selections by Michael Gray will be performed as a set. We do an a cappella selection, and then we'll segue directly into the second one. Hope you enjoy this.
Thank you.
So I had a milestone birthday earlier this month, and I thought it was my turn to do some wordplay of my own, doing a parody of a familiar pop tune, and dedicating it to my wife. But I don't know where she's sitting, because it's dark in here. She's going to be hiding. I'm going to step. Is she here? She's hiding. Well, anyway, this is for my lovely wife, Deb, and I hope you enjoy. And some of the lesser known ones are a little bit on the odd side in the concept musical genre. Merrily We Roll Along went in backwards order. There's all sorts of crazy things that he likes to think about. So as you can see in your program, these are songs that are, some of them are solo songs that were arranged for chorus, but they say a lot about what it means to be an artist and what it means to be working hard for your craft. And so that's the message I'd like the students to receive, and I hope you'll find that message the same way.
Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't.
did not write the music for our last number, but he wrote the text. And having lived through the last several years with the pandemic, and for looking where we need to be in life and where we're moving forward to, I thought it was the ideal piece to end our concert this afternoon from West Side Story, the finale, and we will feature Sophie Ferruzza as our soloist at the beginning, Somewhere.
Thank you.
next song is called Dream with the Angels and was written by Hawaiian composer Zanuck Lindsay in 1996. Now, the song is quite calm and peaceful and, well, angelic, and is supposedly about the composer's mother's journey into the afterlife.
Thank you.
this next song was written by American composer Michael Engelhart in 2016, and it's called Love. Can you guess what it's about? If you guessed love, you're right, because this song is comprised of three sections, each focusing on a different aspect of love. In fact, this song loves love so much that the lyrics consist entirely of one word repeated over and over again. And if you guessed that word was frog, you'd be wrong. This last song we have for you is a traditional American spiritual arranged by American music professor Scott Wilkinson. Now, although this arrangement was made in 1973, this song was originally sung by plantation slaves at least as early as the 1850s, with the first written accounts being found in magazines in 1895. Hope you enjoy Little David.
Next year. So seniors, if you'd like to come down. So hello, my name is Christian Williams. I am a biomedical science major. I will be graduating this semester, and that's a little crazy to say, but I'm taking a gap year, and then I'm actually going to be going to veterinary medicine school.
Hi, I am Margaret Hinkle. I'm obviously a senior. I am a music performance major. My concentration is in flute, but I've been a part of choir all 4 years, and I've loved it. My plans for the future are to next year take a gap year, but then hopefully prepare for auditions for choral conducting.
I'm a psychology major. I'm also graduating along with everybody on the stage. I'm going to take a gap year, and then I'm going to go to grad school for clinical psychology.
Hi, my name is Jack Sullivan. I, much like everyone else on this stage, am graduating. I am a senior majoring in vocal performance and with a minor in theater. And though I do not have any substantial plans yet, I do hope to get my foot in the door theatrically wherever I can and audition anywhere that I can. So I'm very excited.
Hi, my name is Dylan Eckert. I'm also a senior. And I'm going to be working at Menchie's Music Service in the fall.
Hi, my name is Sarah Fluke. I'm one of three Sarahs on this stage right now in the front. I am a senior, of course, music education major with a emphasis in voice. I'm starting the job hunt to find my first teaching job, and my goal is to teach elementary general music.
I'm Grace Lathrop. I study music education and international trade and development, and I'm hoping to secure a job teaching choir at the high school level in the fall.
Hi, I'm Kylie Kutz. I'm also a music education major with a minor in arts administration, so I will also be searching for jobs for this coming fall.
Baker. I'm also a music education major, and I'm searching for jobs in elementary music ed for this fall.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Moser. I am hopefully graduating in the fall. I had to take an extra semester, but I will be graduating in the fall. I am a organ primary, and after graduating, I hope to take a gap year and then further my studies to become a pastor. I will be going to seminary.
Hi, I'm Sarah Bennett, and I'm a music education major, and I also hope to be teaching elementary music. We'll see.
I'm Sarah Gomez, and I'm a music education major with a voice concentration, and I'm hoping to find a job in music education at any level.
Hi everyone, I'm Tyler Shadle. I'm actually a sophomore graduating 2 years early. All kids aside. I will hopefully be I'm graduating with degrees in vocal performance and theater performance, hopefully starting up a studio to teach those things while auditioning for things and maybe going to grad school for choral conducting one day. We'll see. But that's where I'm at. There it is.
Hi, I'm Chloe Aquaviva. I'm a double major in music performance and theater performance as well. I am currently in the middle of auditioning for anything and everything, hoping to secure season-long contracts at some regional theaters in the East Coast.
So. Butler University in the fall to obtain my master's in piano performance.
Hi, I'm Shreya Adhikari. I'm a marketing major, and this fall I will be working in a marketing agency. Achievement. So this piece is from that program. This is Tesfa Wandamagane, who's A Dream Within a Dream. be West, Bucks West High School, but he never got a formal recording of it. So he asked us, this was actually pre-pandemic, if we'd be willing to create a performance for him that he could have as an archived recording. And this is the first opportunity we've had to do that. So we're very happy to honor Mr. Demetz and his work. Before I'll begin,
thank you. Come here.
actual words in this piece. So we hope you just enjoy the humor in it and that we pull it off the way we try to every time. And then I just want to thank you all for coming out today, and please feel free at the conclusion of our concert to please join us in the lobby for a light refreshment. We would love just an opportunity to say thank you and for joining us today. And so without further ado, gracias.
Oh!